Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we are discussing very special IC that is used in this board, and its basic working is to monitor the input primary current. It is current sense IC. It will monitor the current, how much AC current is entering in the system, because here is bridge rectifier, PFC section, IPM module, and it is driving compressor, and if there is short circuit, it can damage everything. To protect from any damage, the primary current is monitored very carefully, and its real-time amount, how much current is flowing in the system, is always transmitted to the microcontroller here in this section. We will see how this current is monitored in the board. Its part number is ACS710T KLA-25CB, and if we check its pin out, this is index pin, pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. Four pins are connected at the same point, and the second four pins are connected to the second point. If we see the internal structure of this IC, this is input current and this point is output. Here is 1 milliohm shunt resistance. The current will flow here. It will magnetize this inductor because it is using 1 milliohm, so it will not dissipate too much power. Proportional to this current, there will a magnetic field. This magnetic field will cause to conduct Hall effect sensor IC here, then Hall amplifier. This will amplify the real time amount of current and it will give output. First, it will receive enable signal, VOC. When these inputs are provided here, it will provide VZCR, reference voltage. Current will flow here from one point to second point. If you see here, from here to here, current will flow. How much current is flowing? That will create magnetic field in this inductor, and this circuit will sense the voltage. This circuit will sense and it will amplify. The output will directly proportional to the amount of current. Maximum 25 ampere current can be sensed here. Here is pin definition. These four and these four. Eight pins are used for primary current, and this is signal area. Activation signal VCC, output error VI out. This is its main signal. Reference voltage and filter. External filter capacitor is connected here to adjust its bandwidth. Pin number 16. It is connected directly to microcontroller. For normal current measurement, how much current is flowing in the system, it will provide output at pin number 12. This is output pin. From here, the signal will go to the microcontroller. This signal, it is reaching at this point, then it is passing to these pins, and then it is reaching here. It is reaching to this point, that is input current signal. Pin number 12 will receive signal here, and this 12 number pin of microcontroller is connected to VI out. When the microcontroller will receive turn on command, power on command through its indoor unit from this communication network, it will receive command and then it will turn on CT enable, current transducer enable. This enable signal will reach to pin number 16 of this IC. From here, CT enable signal will come to pin number 16. This IC will become active. Standby power signal, which we discussed in our last video, that time this IC will turn on. Initially this power supply will turn on, then it will receive standby on command from this optocoupler. This IC will turn on. It will provide 15 volt and 5 volt. This 15 volt will reach here to bias up this IC. Pin number 14 and pin number 9 is ground. Then VOC, it is programmable pin. Here analog reference is applied and we set the maximum top limit. So this IC can be programmed, maximum limit is 25 ampere. It can be programmed to any ampere level based on analog signal. When this analog signal will reach here, for example, we apply 5 volt, when these applied voltage will reach equal to 5 volt, it will create fault condition that there is top level current. If we adjust it up to 15 ampere, when the primary current will try to exceed 15 ampere, it will create fault condition. The normal voltage will come out from this point, 10 ampere, proportional voltage will reach here. These are linear voltage because here is linear Hall effect sensor. So microcontroller will receive these two signals, and if there is any abnormal condition at that time, it will provide error signal. If we check pin number 15 here, voltage divider RH and RL, two resistors are connected. These are used to set VOC signal. Then VCC signal. VCC signal is applied at pin number 14. Fault enabled signal is input signal. Then VI out. What is the output current? This is output signal that is relative to input primary current. This current can be DC or it may be AC. Any current can be applied here. There are two different versions. One is latching and second is non-latching. In this board, it is using CB, that is latching output. If there is NL, that is non-latching. 6 ampere, 12 ampere, 25 ampere. In this board, it is using 25 ampere CB, latching version. Here is block diagram for non-latching and latching. Its detailed parameters are covered here in this chapter. Its function, its role is similar to this transformer. In this board, one wire AC input line is passed through this window of this CT, current transducer, current transformer. How much current will flow? The outdoor unit compressor will draw the current. It will tape voltage in this winding, secondary winding. These voltage then are passed to the other side. Then these voltage are rectified and these are passed to the microcontroller. Microcontroller will understand how much current is flowing. In overcurrent condition, this microcontroller will cut the drive. Same way here, current is passing through this core and on the same core there is secondary winding, these white wires. These are passed to the board and then here is rectifier and capacitors. Then these voltage are sampled for microcontroller. So microcontroller will calculate the amount of current for the system. There is another current sense technique that is here. Shunt resistance is used. IGBT, transistors, whatsoever. How much current will flow here? It will cause to drop voltage here. These voltage are provided to microcontroller. Same in welding machines, current is passed through a shunt resistance. Very low ohmic value resistor is used. The voltage dropped across this shunt resistance are applied to the next circuit. That will process. Here it is using Hall effect sensor technique. Initially voltage are applied here. These voltage will reach to this relay. That is startup relay, soft start relay. After that voltage are reaching to this resistor, then from here to this point inside of the board. When the capacitor will charge at specific level, at that time this relay will turn on, this 30 ampere relay, this will turn on and it will pass full current, all the current which is going to our power stage will pass through this current sense IC. It will measure, it will translate the real-time amount of current. It will give to microcontroller, microcontroller will calculate it. When it will reach at upper limit, then it will turn off this circuit, soft starter circuit. It will cut the drive for this relay to protect the circuit from any further damage. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.